Hi, this is Bob, and I'm going to go over the differences between the stock Ruger LC9 trigger bar and the new Galloway 35% trigger bar. I've measured some of these things. I've used this is like a dial vernier caliper gauge, they call that, and we can take some of the measurements. I've already made the measurements. These trigger bars have actually been in and out, so we're going to go over them. Most of them are pretty minor differences. There are a couple things that do amount to something major. Okay, the overall length, and I'm referring from the outside to the outside. Lengthwise, overall, the Galloway trigger bar is shorter, and it's shorter by a little over a 16th of an inch. And I can show you real easy because I can put these together. I'm going to put a punch in there, and there that punch will hold them both. I'm going to tip them up, and by holding them together, you can see the Galloway is on top, and you can see it is shorter. Okay, not that that makes a difference. I'm guessing the shorter part of it was designed basically to eliminate some of the free play at the start of the trigger pull. And as long as I have them up here, you can see the area that actually pulls, and I've got to take a marker here, it'd be this area right here, that little section right in there, that little flat. Again, the flat on that one, I got to hold the punch straight so these things are accurate. You can see the distance is pretty similar on the two. You know, it's the Galloway is still a little bit shorter, but they're pretty similar as far as where that edge that picks up the hammer. Okay, the next dimension we're going to look at is the width of the tabs, and we're looking at the width of the tab from outside to here, outside to here, and I'm going to use the machined area that would be that area, leading edge there and that leading edge there, and they're basically the same. Again, they're within a couple of thousand, so we're not going to mention anything about that. Now, what does make a difference is, and I'm going to use the Galloway bar initially, is the distance from the outside to this part. I'm calling that the length of the tab, from there to here. The Galloway bar is 0.03 of an inch. The stock bar is only 0.255 of an inch. That's 0.045. And I think in some guns, that's going to create an issue. And like I said, that's one of the things that I've seen that there might be a little bit of a problem with. The width should not be a problem, but the length going this way is probably going to be an issue. And the other thing that I found that could create a little bit problem is if you look at where the holes are, you see there's a thinner amount of metal from the edge to the edge of the hole. And there's more metal from the edge to the edge of the hole, and there's almost 0.20 of a difference, meaning this hole is higher, closer to the top edge than this particular bar. So the Galloway is, that hole is raised up higher than it is on the stock bar. And as far as the thickness, the metal thickness, they're both exactly the same. There's one other thing that I'm going to point out, and I'm going to put a little drawing I have here. Put this up here. We'll get in here as reasonably close as we can and get this set up on there. We'll just take a second here. Okay, right around there. Let me see if I can get in a little bit closer here. Okay, now all I got to do is clear that up a little bit. Okay, nice and clear. That is a sketch, and what I did is I traced the stock trigger bar. I had to trace one or the other. Okay, if I get it lined up properly, as close as I can do, but I know my finger is in here taking some of the light out of here, so it's harder for you to see it. It lines up pretty good. Okay, and I gotta get my hand down here and get it down on the bottom here. I can see it's not showing very good, and right about like that. Okay, those lines are all lining up pretty good. I'm going to lighten this up a little bit. It's not, personally, it's not light enough, and it's because I'm against the bright piece of paper, so we're going to lighten that up a little bit in there. And Problem is now it doesn't look like it's as clear as it should be. Yeah, it looks pretty clear. Let me move it a little closer here. We'll get it clear. Let me get my finger again down at the bottom so the light works. Okay. Sketch to sketch. It lines up now. Like I say, I'm trying to hold it with my finger. But it lines up. It's perfect because I sketched it. Okay. And I don't mean that I'm perfect. I mean it's a, you lay something down, hold it down, and run around with it with a very small lead pencil. You're going to get something that comes out pretty accurate. Now we're going to put the Galloway trigger bar up. First thing, of course, you'll notice is I'm trying to line it up. This is the important part. This little profile here, which causes the trigger bar to drop, which releases the hammer at the break point. So that's the critical point. So I'm going to line that up right there as close as I can. Then I'm going to show you what I'm finding are the differences. Basically, you can see I've got some red arrows drawn. Well, it's higher. This particular bar is a little higher here, and it's also higher here. And if you can see the angle, and I think if you look at the trace line, you can see that the trigger bar, I can see the line here, the trace line, but I can't see the trigger line here. So it's raised up higher here. It's raised up higher there. Okay. And those, again, can create an issue. And I just wanted to point it out. Other than that, it looks pretty well the same. But we're reviewing one bar to the other, so we want to make sure we've got it reasonably accurate. That's basically it. I just wanted to show the differences that I found, and some of those differences could create an issue. Thanks for watching. Okay, I want to add one other thing to that. I'm going to splice this thing into that video that I just made. Is I want to show the difference between the two notch and the single notch bar. And let me just see if I can focus in. There we go. Okay. I've got, this is the double notch bar. Okay. And I think you can pretty well see those notches in there. I'm going to see if I can get in just a little bit closer here. See if we can get focused in a little bit closer here. Okay, that looks like I can get in a little bit closer. I got a white background on there. And looking at this thing, you can see the notches. And what we've got, I'm going to switch hands so I can use the pen here a little bit better here. And as close as I can and keep it in focus. There we go. Okay. You can see you've got a machined area right there. We've got another machined area right there, and that is actually the outside of the trigger bar before anything was machined on it right there, okay? So what you're dealing with those notches, everybody has a single notch, has this notch right here, okay? But the difference is, because they don't have the machining there, that notch looks deeper. The metal comes out and comes back. It's going to be the same height. The metal is going to be the same line as this one right there, okay? So that would be the single notch bar, would look like that, okay? This is a double notch bar, and the only difference is, instead of just having the one notch right in the end here, then they machined a little bit more material there, which is supposed to reduce the amount of rise on the blocker lever. So that's the only difference between the two bars. So if you have a single notch bar and it's working fine, then that's all you need. You don't need the double notch bar, which is what this one is right here. And we'll turn it around and see if the notches show up any better on the back. I don't think they will. I think you can just see that. And again, if I get in too close, it gets blurry. But the difference between the single notch and the double notch bar is just that extra little notch that they machined in there. Okay. And you do not need that. If you've got a single notch bar and it's working fine, it's not going to work better with a double notch bar. Matter of fact, it could create a problem because your blocker lever may not lift high enough to allow the firing pin blocker to clear the firing pin. So your hammer will drop and the gun may not go boom. So if your gun's working fine, you have no issues, then don't worry about this extra notch in the bar. That's it. Thanks for watching.